Okay, this is a quick tutorial on using paste in place to create a mortise. So I've got here a leg and an apron, and if I orbit around here a little bit and go to X-ray, I can see the apron with the tenon there. So in order to do this, I need to select the tenon first. So I'm going to select the leg and hide it. So I need to open the apron for editing so I can select just the tenon. And I'm going to orbit around here so that when I put the selection box around the tenon, I'm only selecting the tenon and not selecting these lines at the top and bottom there. So that should give me a good perspective to do that. I'm going to go to the select tool and I'm going to draw a bounding box just around there. The only thing I need to be concerned about are those lines at the top and bottom on the shoulder there. So that looks good. If I orbit, I can say I only have the tenon. So I'm going to go over to edit and copy. So that copies that to the clipboard. I'm going to select outside of here and unhide the leg. I have a shortcut for that. So I can orbit around here. My leg's back in place. So I'm going to select the apron and hide it. So it's gone. And now I need to open this leg for editing and put the tenon into the leg. So here's where I use paste in place. So I come up to edit, paste in place, and the tenon comes right back in. But now, since it's placed in the leg, it becomes the mortise. So that's it. I'm going to select outside of here. Now, because the tenon became the mortise, the faces are reversed. So I'm going to select a correct face that's white on the outside and right-click and say reverse faces. And you see when I click this, the mortise faces will change. Oh, not that. That was reverse faces. I'm going to undo that, right-click, and orient faces. There we go. That was the correct command. That looks good. I can select outside of here, zoom back out. I will unhide the apron, and I'm all set.